Baseball Asterisk now presents the history of Major League Baseball Seattle Pilots. The Seattle Pilots were an American professional baseball team based in Seattle, Washington during the 1969 Major League Baseball season. During their single-season existence, the Pilots played their home games at Six Stadium and were a member of the West Division of Major League Baseball's American League. On April 1, 1970, the franchise moved to Milwaukee, Wisconsin and became the Milwaukee Brewers. The Pilots' name originated from the owner's part-time job as a harbor pilot and the city's association with the aviation industry. The team colors were royal blue and gold, with accessory red in the logo, helm and baseball seams. Seattle had long been a hotbed for minor league baseball and was home to the Seattle Rainiers, a successful team in the Pacific Coast League, PCL. At the time, Seattle was the third biggest metropolitan area on the West Coast. The Cleveland Indians briefly considered a move to Seattle in 1964 but opted to stay in Ohio. In 1967, Charles Finley looked to move his Kansas City Athletics to Seattle, but ended up moving the Athletics to Oakland, California. There was no real competition from other professional teams at the time. While Seattle had landed the National Basketball Association's Supersonics in 1967, the NBA was not as popular as baseball was at the time. The NFL would come to the city in 1976 with the addition of the expansion Seahawks. Schultz and Milks both optimistically predicted that the Pilots could finish third in the newly formed, six-team American League West. However, the Pilots experienced the typical struggles of a first-year expansion team. They won their first game, and then their home opener 3 days later, but only won five more times in the first month. Nevertheless, the Pilots managed to stay in reasonable striking distance of .500. At least through June, and were only six games back of the division lead as late as June 28. But a disastrous 9-20 July, and an even worse 6-22 August, ended even a faint hope of any kind of contention, though they were still in third place as late as August. The team finished the season in last place in the AL West with a record of 64-98, 33 games behind division winners Minnesota, and 45 games behind league-leading Baltimore. However, the team's poor play was the least of its troubles. The most obvious problem was Six Stadium. The longtime home of the Rainiers, It had once been considered one of the best ballparks in minor league baseball. By the 1960s, however, it was considered far behind the times. While a condition of awarding the Pilots to Seattle was that 6 had to be expanded to 30,000 seats, only 19,500 seats were ready by opening day because of numerous delays. The scoreboard was not even ready until the night before the season opener. By June, there were finally 25,000 seats in place. Water pressure was almost non-existent after the seventh inning, especially with crowds above 8,000. The Pilots had a total attendance of 677,944 people for the season, 20th in the 24-team league, and their average attendance per game, 8,268, was also 20th. Seattle finished above fellow cellar-dweller teams like the Cleveland Indians, Chicago White Sox, Philadelphia Phillies, and the expansion San Diego Padres. The other two expansion teams outdrew the Pilots, with the Kansas City Royals having 902,414 attend their games while the Montreal Expos finished 10th in attendance with 1,212,608. The highest attendance for a Pilots home game was 23,657, on August 3 against the New York Yankees. The lowest attendance for a Pilot home game was on April 29, their 17th game, when a reported 1,954 fans showed up to watch them play the California Angels. The Pilots lost several hundred thousand dollars their first and only season. The team's new stadium was slated to be built at the Seattle Center, but a petition by stadium opponents ground the project to a halt. The project was later moved to south of downtown and developed for the Kingdom, 10, since replaced by Safeco Field, now T-Mobile Park. By the end of the season, the Pilots were gasping. However, Daly refused to put up more financing. It was obvious that they would not survive long enough to move into their new park without new ownership. It was also obvious that the timetable for a new stadium would have to be significantly advanced, as 6 Stadium was inadequate even for temporary use. During the offseason, Soriano made contact with car salesman and former Milwaukee Braves minority owner Bud Selig, who was leading the effort to bring Major League Baseball back to Milwaukee. They met in secret for over a month towards the end of the season, and during Game 1 of the World Series, Soriano agreed to sell the Pilots to Selig for $10.8 million. Selig would then move the team to Milwaukee. However, the remaining owners of the Pilots turned it down in the face of pressure from Washington State's two senators, Warren Magnuson and Henry M. Scoop Jackson, as well as State Attorney General Slade Gorton. Local theater chain owner Fred Danz came forward in October 1969 with a $10 million deal, but it fizzled when the Bank of California called in a $4 million loan it had made to Soriano and Daly to finance the purchase of the franchise. In January 1970, Westin Hotels head Eddie Carlson put together a non-profit group to buy the team. However, the owners of the other major league teams rejected the idea almost out of hand, since it would have devalued the other club's worth. A slightly modified deal came one vote short of approval. After a winter and spring full of court action, the Pilots reported for spring training under new manager Dave Bristol, unsure of where they would play. The owners had given tentative approval to the Milwaukee group, but the state of Washington got an injunction on March 16 to stop the deal. PNSI immediately filed for bankruptcy, a move intended to forestall post-sale legal action. At the bankruptcy hearing a week later, Milks testified there was not enough money to pay the coaches, players, and office staff. Had Milks been more than 10 days late in paying the players, they would have all become free agents and left Seattle without a team for the 1970 season. With this in mind, federal bankruptcy referee Sidney Volin declared the Pilots bankrupt on April 1, 6 days before opening day, clearing the way for them to move to Milwaukee. The team's equipment had been sitting in Provo, Utah, with the drivers awaiting word on whether to drive toward Seattle or Milwaukee. The move came so late that Selig had to scrap his initial plans to change the team's colors to navy and red in honor of the minor league Brewers of his youth. Instead, the Brewers were stuck using old Pilots uniforms, with the team name replaced. One legacy of the Brewers' roots in Seattle is that their colors are still blue and gold, although the shades have been darker since 2000. Jim Boughton was a Pilots relief pitcher through most of 1969, having been sold to the Seattle Pilots by the New York Yankees in mid-1968. His classic baseball book Ball 4 is based on a journal that Boughton kept during the season. Boughton spent much of the season with Seattle, although he was traded to the Houston Astros before the 1969 season ended. Inside pitch, Bob Sonbichler and Jim Kittlesby were administrators working for the Seattle Pilots through the bankruptcy and moved on to Milwaukee to help that startup. Sonbichler, in fact, was the chief financial officer for both teams. Inside pitch, much like Ball 4, chronicles their insider memories of that same 1969 season, pulling back the curtain on the front office characters in suits and ties much as Ball 4 did in the clubhouse and dugout for the guys wearing cleats and gloves. They also share stories about the very early months in the Milwaukee transition, also from the perspective of front office insiders. Inside pitch helps to round out the picture of the star-crossed 1969 Seattle Pilots. In 1970, in the aftermath of the Pilots' purchase and relocation to Milwaukee, the city of Seattle, King County, and the state of Washington, represented by then-State Attorney General Slade Gorton, sued the American League for breach of contract. Confident that Major League Baseball would return to Seattle within a few years, King County built the multi-purpose kingdom, which would become home to the NFL's expansion Seattle Seahawks in 1976. The Pilots' lawsuit continued until 1976. At trial, the American League offered to give Seattle an expansion baseball franchise in return for dropping the suit, 36, and details were ironed out over the next year. To keep the league with an even number of teams, a formal expansion proceeding was held, with a second team, the Blue Jays, being awarded to the City of Toronto, also allowing both leagues to place a team in Canada. The National League's Montreal Expos having been established in 1969. The new Seattle team, to begin play in 1977, would be owned by entertainer Danny Kaye, along with Stanley Golub, Walter Schoenfeld, Lester Smith, James Stilwell Jr. and James A. Walsh. Seattle's new team would be known as the Mariners, and would initially incorporate the same blue and gold colors used by the Pilots.